इमार्टल पावर कौमुदी सिप सुदीप सिप समिता सिप रूप सिप गौतम सिप अशोक निशानी सिप रेखा सिप गौरिश एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ यू आई कैन नॉट सी आई कैन सी अविनाश सिप अविनाश सिप अविनाश सिप कोमल एंड मेनी ऑफ यू हु आर ऑन ऑडियो बट नॉट ऑन वीडियो आई वेलकम यू टू दिस इवनिंग्स क्वेश्चन दैट समबडी ऑलवेज आस्क मी एंड द क्वेश्चन इज अ वेरी सिंपल अ वेरी ऑर्डिनरी क्वेश्चन बट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन एंड द क्वेश्चन इज दिस वॉट इज द पर्पज ऑफ लाइफ What is the purpose of life? I put the question back to you. Who would like to give me this answer to the simple question? What is the purpose of life?
Shivam sir ji.
Shivam, Ashok, bolo.
The purpose of life is to seek enlightenment. To get connected to God.
Why?
इट्स द मेन आवर मेन लक्ष्य वो है कि हम भगवान से मिले.
अरे क्यों टाइम वेस्ट करता है यार, खाओ पियो जियो एंजॉय लाइफ. व्हाई यू वांट ऑल दिस एनलाइटनमेंट एंड ऑल, व्हाट इज द यूज?
नो सर, दैट खाओ पियो जियो विल नॉट हेल्प अस, इट्स ओनली टेम्पररी. एंड मेन थिंग इज दैट वी शुड do something for others. God has given us this life to do something for others, not only ourselves.
Who sent me this message? I think it was Preeti. She's on the line, but I think Preeti sent me this message today morning only, Ashok. And in her message, she told me there are no others. There are no others. I wish I could share that picture with you all. There are no others, Ashok. Ramana Maharshi, how should we live? Ramana Maharshi was asked this question. When he was asked this question, Preeti sent this message to me. Ramana Maharshi was asked the question, how should we treat others? And Ramana Maharshi replied, there are no others. We are all one.
We are so, one.
This is from our spiritual director, Preeti Vaishnav, who is on the call. But so Ashok, I appreciate what you are saying. I don't. The moment on one point you are saying we want enlightenment, very good. You need enlightenment. On the second point you are saying I want to do something for others. No, Ashok, this is what enlightenment gives us. Enlightenment gives us the realization that there are no others. You and me, Ashok, are appearing as two, but we are only one. Okay, thank you, Ashok. I think we have the next question is from Amitash, what is the purpose of life?
Shivoham, Master, the purpose of life is God realization.
So, why do you say that?
Master, I say that because that is the only truth. The rest all is Maya. And as a logical human being, we should seek the truth.
And what is God realization, Amitash, according to you?
Come again, Master.
And what is God realization according to you?
God realization, according to me, is Master realizing that God is the supreme truth. That is God realization.
So God realization, if you tell people, if you want to really make people realize, you have to say God realization is to realize that God is not God. God is Sip. Because the moment you say God, people think of Krishna, Shiva, Jesus and the others. So,
yes,
God is not God. God is Sip. Okay. Now you're coming to the point. Yes, the purpose of, one of the purpose of life is, Ashok Nichani said, the purpose of life is enlightenment. Amitash is saying the purpose of life is God realization. What do others think? All of you are coming on this call every day. What is the purpose of life? Bolo, come on. Tell me.
Guruji.
Namaste, sir.
Bolo. Mataji, bolo.
Shivoham Guruji, Pranam Guruji, not to come again to this world. Merge with God.
Okay. The purpose of life, according to Ru Mataji, is The purpose of life is not to return to this earth, not to take rebirth, to be liberated and to be united. But I'm still leaving it open.
Sir,
what is the purpose of life?
Sir, for moksha, sir. Moksha, sir.
This is Tushar.
Yes, sir.
So, Tushar, the purpose of life according to you is moksha. And what is moksha?
Bliss, sir. Experiencing the Paramanand, the Atma, sir. Experiencing.
So, is it different from what Rumataji said? It is unification with God, or you have a different understanding?
Sir, unification with God, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Same.
Okay, good. So, the purpose of life, according to Tushar, is moksha. And some people call it nirvana. So, if it's nirvana or moksha. So, I still want you all to take another 5 minutes on this subject. What is the purpose of life?
Shivam, sir.
Shivam, Sudeep.
Sir, I'll use one of your quotes only. The purpose of life is to find out the purpose of life.
Excellent.
Excellent. First continue, Sudeep. And then once we realize what the purpose is, for me, that purpose would be to stay in Satchidanand, but not Sudeep, to get affected by whatever is happening around me. Yes, sir, please.
So you can. I'm sorry, I have this bad.
No. Yeah, my point was just to be in Satchidanand,
okay,
and be united with God, and not to get, at least for me, it's like not to get affected with what is happening around me, that all that is Maya. And I should keep myself away from it and just be an observer.
And what will that give you?
Well, that will lead me to Satchidanand, I believe.
And Satchidanand, why you need Satchidanand?
Because that is where I get united with God. Because I, even while alive, I will realize that it's all God around me. I am nothing and it's all God.
So are you only looking for that God, that Satchidananda, only for after you are... Later, is there any benefit today, or you're looking for that
today, sir?
What is the benefit? Today's
benefit would be that I will not be getting affected by what's happening around me. So I'll just be an observer, not getting affected by it.
I love Sudeep's answer. Sudeep says the purpose of life. What is the purpose of life? The purpose of life is to find the purpose of life. The purpose of life. I hope we should write a book like this. Eru should note, this book is a good topic. The purpose of life is to find the purpose of life. My dear friends, you know, Sudeep has spoken something very beautiful. He says that the purpose of life is to reach that state of Sat Chit Anand. Do people even understand the meaning? What is the Sat Chit Anand? The Sat Chit Anand is not just one glass of beer, or not going with your boyfriend in the cabin in a park and behind the roses, or not having one chicken biryani, or not buying a diamond necklace. No. Satchit Anand is a deep bliss. It is deep. I'm not stuck. Voice is not stuck. I'm just telling you, it is deep bliss and peace. It is so deep that I cannot keep on saying, I can't. It is so deep. We are chasing pleasure. My dear friends, the pleasure doesn't last. How many of you enjoy the bliss I enjoy, which is, I am always in a high. It looks like I've had 3 pegs of rum every 5 minutes. It looks like I'm having whiskey every half an hour. How many of you feel like that? How many of you feel like, you know, I feel like I've had ganja, or I've had nicotine, or I've had, what do you call this, bhang. I feel I am on that. I feel such a deep bliss. That is Sat Chit Anand. That is Ananda. That is what I call nirvana. How many of you experience nirvana? So Sudeep has brought about a beautiful point. The purpose of life is to realize the purpose of life, to reach that state of ananda, to reach, there is no misery, my friends. How do you reach a situation where there is no problem? When I have a problem, immediately the problem becomes no problem. How? Because many problems, one solution. All the problems in this world has got one solution. All the problem. All. A-L-L-L-L-L-L-L-L. How? बट यू से बट मैं क्या करूं, मेरा दादा ऐसा बोलता है, मेरी नानी ऐसे बोलती है, माई ग्रैंड फादर, माई ग्रैंड सन, माई डॉटर, माई सन इन लॉ. या यू आर कॉट, यू हैव क्रिएटेड अ प्रिजन. एंड यू से व्हाट हैपेंड माई लुई विटॉन बैग, एंड व्हाट हैपेंड टू माई गोल्डन बैंगल, एंड व्हाट हैपेंड टू माई न्यू सिल्क साड़ी. You are so caught by the illusions of life that you don't realize that this life is a beautiful dream. Life is just a dream. There is no need to scream. When will you realize the purpose of this life is to realize the purpose of this life? Who else would like to try? Who?
Komal sir.
हाँ कोमल बोलो बोलो, हम तो आपको सुनने के लिए वेट करते हैं. बोलो कोमल.
Sir, I am, my purpose of life is to work so hard that the electricity should touch the filament of the bulb and I should enjoy that aha moment.
You are giving nice poetry today. That the electric, I have to understand what you're trying to say.
The electricity is sip.
Yeah.
The bulb always has a filament.
Yeah, which is you, which is your body.
Yes. So you want? That aha moment.
So the sip is already in you. No, what are you waiting for that aha moment? Now only say, aha, ha. Now only say, nah. Why are you not saying now?
I'm not working hard, sir.
And why you are not working hard? What is stopping you from working hard?
Too many distractions.
What are
you? I understand. But I am overcoming one by one now.
So you know the distraction. You know the distractions that are causing your problems.
I'm working upon it, sir.
I wish you the best. And remember this. You have to drop them. You have to let go. There is no other way. If you cling on to your distractions, if you cling on to the illusions of this world, you will not experience this bliss. My dear friends, you know, why do I tell you all so much to experience this bliss? Why? Because I enjoy it. I truly enjoy this ananda. And I'm telling you, it's not that I've given up. Have I given up anything? Even today I had my favorite masala dosa. Just now I ate nice masala dosa. But it's not that I crave for it. No. I enjoyed it because I enjoyed it. But it is not that I'm a slave of masala dosa. No. The problem is we are slaves. And we take our slavery to our grave. And we are what I like Komal's honesty. Komal, and I don't expect to have more openness than what you have told. Komal says, I have to work hard because my body is like a filament. And the electricity is not switching on the enlightenment in my body because the filament is so covered by layers of ignorance or layers of attachments, layers of distractions, that the current is not touching the filament. So she's very clear. She knows that the current has to touch the filament for her to experience Sachidanand. She knows. She understands. She comes every Monday for bhajans. She watches probably on Facebook if she doesn't come. How do we experience that bliss which Sudeep talked about, that Sat Chit Anand, that Buddha called Nirvana? How can we be in that state, my dear friends, of eternal bliss? How can you experience what I call divine love? Do you even understand the meaning of divine love? Do you understand? People think love is just, they think love is just a kiss. No, love is not a kiss. True love is bliss. When will you understand the meaning of beautiful divine love? Love is so divine. People are shy to use the word to say, I love you. They're shy to say, I love you. Why are you shy? Because when you love the soul, when you love the divine, it's ishq hakiki. It is so divine, my dear friends. Eternal peace, divine love. Divine love is so beautiful. Everlasting joy, which has no misery. So how do you reach that state? So continue for another 2 minutes and we go back. I'm so happy with this. No, this is one of the basic questions, right?
Yeah, who wants to speak? Rekha Parvani, Shivoham Air.
Shivoham Rekha, bolo.
I feel the purpose of my life is to realize I'm not the body and not the mind. Jivan Mukta, I want to get. But I know I have to work a lot.
But have you not realized
it? I have realized it. I have realized it. But sometimes I get carried away, very frankly. This is again the relationships which do this
to me. Relationships. What are these relationships? Relationships. Why are our relationships carrying us away? Why are our relationships carrying us away from this eternal bliss and peace? Rekha, what is the cause that we are letting these relationships destroy?
Do I realize? True. I need to work on this, air. I really need to work on this.
Yeah, because see what happens. Let me tell you. I have relationships, no? Is it that I don't have relationships?
Yes.
I do, right? I have relationships.
You do have.
But do my relationships steal my... My realizing, does my realize here relationships steal my satchitana? Do I let my relationships rob my nirvana?
No, not at all. Can you give me some? What should I do? Working towards it.
No. You should be so passionate. You should desire nirvana so much. Mm. That those relationships cannot touch you.
Yes.
You are letting those relationships become prison bars and creating a prison.
Correct.
In which you are getting imprisoned and you are not able to fly in the sky and you cry.
Yes.
So you have to let go. You have to let go. Yes. If you don't let go, then you don't realize, but you will flow, and before you realize it, you will be in the womb of another mother. Of course, being a spiritual seeker, you will be born as a human being, but before you realize it, your next journey will start. You want to come back on earth, you want another rebirth, and you want the same thing, and the same 9 months in the womb, and you cry, and you come out, and then again, who sent me a video? A beautiful video of the journey of life on a cycle, right? That we are riding a cycle, then somebody comes and the cycle goes on, then the children come, then they ride cycle, then the children leave us and they go, then again we are alone and we go. What is so complicated that we come alone and we go alone? We come with nothing and we take nothing. What are we trying to collect? What are we going to get by collecting things? Millions, billions, gold, jewelry, diamonds, houses, properties, shares, stocks. What are you getting excited about? Nothing is ours.
Guruji, आपका तो relation हम सबसे ही बहुत है.
तो मैं थोड़ी आप लोगों से attached हूँ.
Attached तो हैं आप माने न माने. गुरु शागिर्द से जरूर attached होता है.
नहीं मैं आप सबको प्यार करता हूँ, because आप सब रूह है ना.
हाँ.
लेकिन
पर आप प्यार तो करते हैं रूह से, रूह को करते हैं
तो रूह
पर आप, आपके रिलेशन तो सबसे ज्यादा
करना चाहिए ना किरण जी.
तो जो लेकिन अगर आप रूह बनेगी तभी मैं आपको प्यार कर सकता हूँ ना, लेकिन आप बॉडी बनेगी तो मैं कैसे प्यार करूंगा आपको.
नहीं मैं तो रूह बनने की पूरी कोशिश कर रही हूँ.
ओके सो एनीबडी एल्स वांट्स टू टच एनी क्वेश्चन और यू वांट टू मूव. अमिताश,
अविनाश यस सो या सर, व्हेनेवर आई थिंक अबाउट इट, द फर्स्ट आंसर इज दैट पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ इज टू डाई पीसफुली, एंड सेकंड थिंग दैट आई नो लाइक पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ इज टू लिव moment by moment, not moment by moment, live in the moment. So that are the two things I know and I work on.
But Avinash, if you live in the moment but you are not happy, then what is the use? If you are living in the moment and you have desires and passions and you are slave of your mind and you are slave of, and you are on a ghoda and the horse is riding 19, 20, 21, no, you were there for the session, right? Man, they asked the man, where are you going? He said, ask the horse. So if you are in the moment, the beauty is, Avinash, is if you can be in the moment with consciousness. If you can be in the moment with Sat Chit Anand, it is not only being in the moment. Even the coolie is in the moment. even the coolie is just carrying his the bags on his head, and he is in that moment. He's only thinking about the moment of carrying the bag and getting 100 rupees for eating food tonight with his family. But he's not happy. He is not in Satchit Anand. He has lived as a coolie, he will die as a coolie. So it's not about dying with peace, it's about living with peace. You said I should die in peace. No, I'm sorry, I don't agree with you. Our goal is not to die in peace. You said, no, we should die in peace.
Yes, yes.
No,
yes.
Avinash, we should live with peace. How can, I would like all of you to listen to this before you ask me any other questions. I have now put three things that we should want to live with moment by moment. Peace, love, and joy. We need peace, which is the foundation of happiness. We need love, which is divine. Not just divine love for the body. Because love for the body is going to make you cry. Because love for the body means expectations. Love for the body means disappointments. Love for the body means attachments. Love for the body means possessiveness. No, what are you trying to love the body for? The body is an illusion. The body is meaningless. So you need peace, the foundation, love that is divine, and joy. Joy that is complete bliss, not just a pleasure that comes from a pizza or a burger or an ice cream. No. One, just buying one Nalli sari should not give you the happiness. How does the Nalli sari, some ladies, they think that if they buy the Louis Vuitton, then I know ladies will say, I asked one lady, what is your goal of life? She told me, I have one goal. I said, what? To buy Louis Vuitton bag. What a shallow goal. What a shallow goal. Because she wants to carry the Louis Vuitton and impress everybody in the world. Is that what your life goal is? Chalo. Let's get back to questions. I hope you enjoyed this question. What is the purpose of life? But I would like to open the session to any question now. Of course, you can stick to this question. But any more questions? And as I told you, don't come after 8:30 running for the question. Ask now. Now the stage is empty. Ask now.
Shivu Umar.
Sip, okay. Sip is Avinash. He has put sip. Shivo Amrekha, bolo.
Actually, when I saw your video that the purpose of life is to know the purpose of life. मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा ये सुन के कि मुझे कभी पता ही नहीं था कि ऐसा कभी होता है कि द पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ इज टू नो द पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ एंड दैट वन थिंग मेड मी टू कम ऑन दिस कॉल एंड आफ्टर कमिंग टू दिस कॉल एंड नाउ आई एम एबल टू रियलाइज दैट दिस ऑल इज माया बट नाउ आई नीड टू गो फॉरवर्ड लाइक अब समझ में आ रहा है कि ये माया है But now I want to clear one thing that I am the child of SIP or I am the SIP or I am a part of the SIP. This is all a confusion.
Okay, the first thing you must know is the one person causing the confusion is your mind. So first you must know who's causing the confusion. And if you want to overcome the confusion of this question and any other question in life, You must make the monkey mind into a monk. Means you must be still. You must be still. Now it's like asking, ke maine from a matka of water, I took from the matka of water, I took one small little bucket, one small small cup, and I made put in a ice tray, it became ice. Now these pieces of ice, now are these pieces of ice born from the matka? Or they are born from the water, or where this ice came from, who manufactured the ice. You know the answer, or I have to tell you?
No, I didn't understand.
Ice kaise banta hai? Ab you take water from a matka, you put in the ice tray, you put in the refrigerator, it becomes ice, correct? So is the ice different from the water?
Nahi, wo paani se hi banta hai na?
Usi paani se banta hai ya aur swarg aur heaven se koi paani aata hai?
बोला कि यू हैव टू थिंक योर डॉटर एज शी इज द डॉटर ऑफ गॉड
या बिकॉज यू आर थिंकिंग द आइस क्यूब इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द वॉटर ना इफ यू टेक द आइस क्यूब एंड यू पुट इट इन द पॉट ऑफ वॉटर विल द आइस क्यूब रिमेन आइस क्यूब
नो इट विल मिंगल टू वॉटर ओनली
आइस क्यूब केम फ्रॉम वेयर
फ्रॉम वॉटर
एंड इट गोज बैक इनटू वेयर
Here I'm not able to understand.
No, because you're not willing to listen. Because I am I am talking about ice cube and water, and your mind is on you and your daughter. But how can you understand when I am talking about water and ice, and you are thinking of your daughter? Then you cannot pay attention to the question.
Okay.
Where from the water we created the cube of ice, from the ice it goes back into water. Is that difficult to understand?
No, that is not difficult. मतलब ice cube पानी से बना है वो और वही पानी से बना है ना.
And if you put the ice cube back in the water, is it separate from the water? It will melt. It will melt in the same water. So where did you come from? When you were born, you were just one small dot. You were one cell of zygote. School mein padha nahi padha. School mein you learned that the body starts with one small cell. Then the body, legs are formed, hands are formed, embryo is formed. Is this complicated to understand?
No.
So therefore the body is formed in the stomach. Tumhare maa ke stomach mein koi factory hai kya?
नहीं वो तो भगवान ने बनाया है हमें ना.
तुम्हें मालूम है ना फिर. तुम्हारे मदर के स्टमक में कोई स्पेशल फैक्ट्री की बच्चा बनाने की फैक्ट्री है.
ये मेरी समझ में आ गया कि I have come here through my parents.
Your parents did nothing. They are just like the ice. जो फ्रिज में जो ट्रे है ना वो ट्रे है बस. वो ट्रे में आइस बनता है. वो ट्रे का कुछ काम नहीं है.
वो मेरी समझ में आ गया.
So we all come from nothing. And we go back to nothing. We come from the spark of energy. And when death happens, that energy leaves. And people say we passed away. We have to realize we are that sip. We are that energy. It appears as ice cube. But actually what it is?
Water.
Correct. You appear as Rekha. But actually what are you?
Okay. Actually I'm Atma.
You're Atma. What is your daughter? What is your daughter?
Like I was thinking.
Wait. What is your daughter? You manufactured your daughter?
No.
Did you create her brain? Did you create her kidneys?
No.
So what is your daughter?
She is also a sip now.
Then you know the answer. You are also sip. She is also sip. Then what is the problem?
Okay. So one thing I want to clear up. So I am not a part of the sip. I am not the daughter of the sip. I am the sip.
Absolutely. But the moment, why I'm giving you analogy now? Because otherwise after this call, your monkey mind will again turn you around. Why am I giving the analogy of water and ice? For you not to forget. If suppose somebody comes and says, this ice is not water, it is ice. Theek hai, right? They're right. Nah. It is not water, it is ice. But jo samajhdar hai, the one who understands, अरे दिस आइस इज नथिंग यार. दिस आइस इज वॉटर. वॉट इज सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. आइस कम्स फ्रॉम वॉटर. दिस इज कॉल्ड द लॉ ऑफ कॉजेशन. नाउ दिस आई एम टेलिंग यू एडवांस. दोज ऑफ यू हु वांट टू गो टू एडवांस क्लास, सुदीप, यू नो द थ्री टेनेट्स ऑफ द लॉ ऑफ कॉजेशन.
सो द वेयरएवर देयर इज एन इफेक्ट देयर इज अ कॉज.
यस,
इफ वी रिमूव द कॉज द इफेक्ट विल आल्सो गेट रिमूव्ड.
Yeah.
And the effect is nothing but the cause in a different form.
Good.
It's like manifestation.
So just jumbled it up a little. The answers are correct, but let me put it clearly. So Rekha, you have to learn, it's called the law of causation. The law of causation says every effect has a cause. Effect matlab ice cube ka cause hai pani.
Okay.
Leher ka matlab hai, leher ka cause hai samundar. Yeah. Anguthi ka cause hai gold.
Huh.
So every effect has a cause.
Huh.
The effect is nothing but the cause in another form. Anguthi sona hai, leher samundar hai, ice pani hai.
Huh.
So point one is every effect has a cause. The effect is nothing but the cause in another form.
Okay.
If you remove the cause, there is no effect. If you remove samundar, there is no leher. If you remove gold, there is no ring. If you remove pani, there is no ice. If you remove sip, there is no rekha.
हाँ 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 समझ में आ गया मुझे समझ में आ गया. So I am not the part of the sip. I am the sip. Clear.
Unless you think that ice cube is not water, it is something else.
नहीं मुझे समुंदर का लहर का आपने example दिया ना सोना का अंगूठी का सब समझ में आया मुझे.
हाँ बस अभी बोलो मत, अभी अभी तुम्हारा मंकी है ना बंदर, ये जो बंदर है ना, तो रू माता जी मैंने मंदिर में क्या कहा याद है आपको? रू माता जी
याद है, याद है
बंदर के बारे में क्या बोला मैंने? याद है? या उम्र के साथ वो चले जाता है,
हमें बॉस बनना है, हमें बॉस बनना है।
मैंने मंदिर में बोला
हॉर्स नहीं बनना है,
मैंने मंदिर में बोला आपको बोला हे बंदर, हे बंदर प्रभु है अंदर, तू ढूंढे मंदिर जागरे बंदर, याद भूल गए क्या? मैंने बोला
वन मोर क्वेश्चन आई हैव दैट यू टोल्ड दैट इन अ हॉर्स मंकी एंड द बॉस, so I actually when horse and boss was there the topic was clear for me, but when the monkey got included again it got a confusion
because of the monkey only, no, because of the monkey it creates confusion.
So what happened is I was thinking like if like humko maine ye analogy try ki ki apne jeevan ki door na monkey ke haath mein deni hai na horse ke haath mein deni hai, jeevan ki door deni hai to boss ke haath mein deni hai.
Correct. Monkey is the mind, and horse is the body, mind, intellect. It's just an analogy. Ye to actually monkey is monkey, horse is horse. In our life, the monkey is the mind that's jumping from thought to thought. The horse is the body, mind, ego that is galloping and wasting our life. And we should not be monkey, which is the mind. We should not be horse, body, mind, intellect. We should be the boss, the Atma. Thank you, Amitash. Amitash has a question. Good Thank question, you. Rekha. Thank you. Amitash?
Shivoham, Master. Master, Shivoham. You have said sometimes that this all ways of worshipping God through puja is basically, I mean, not the best way to reach out to God. So, Master, do you denounce these things or like what is the take? Is it beneficial or not, Master? That's my question.
Amitash, I'm asking you a question. If you see a scientist of NASA, you know NASA, right?
Yes,
if you
Master.
See a scientist of NASA and he's reading A for apple, B for ball, C for cat, what you'll say?
That looks weird, Master, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah,
you'll
that's
say,
weird.
What a bloody fool, man. You're a scientist of NASA and you're reading A for apple, B for ball, C for cat. But if you see a four-year-old child reciting this A for apple, B for ball, what will you say?
Yes, it seems normal, natural.
So, for people who have not reached NASA, in this
okay. sense,
who have not reached the sense state of realization or enlightenment, then they have to keep on praying to God in the form of God, right?
Yes, Master.
But the moment you are on a quest, like you have already come on this call, if you come on this call, but you still believe God is a statue, then you have not learnt anything.
Master, so, then we say Shivoham, then we are also saying one God name.
No, Shivoham means Shiva is inside you. And Shiva is not Shiva. Shiva is the power of God. So if you have not paid attention, please listen to this carefully. You should not pray to Shiva. You should pray through Shiva. Shiva is just a form through which you should pray.
Okay.
You should never pray. You should never pray to a God with a name and form. You've got to pray through the God that has got a name and form.
Okay, Master.
You got the point? So just
yes,
to
Master.
Tell you, I went to Sringeri and met his Holiness, the Shankaracharya, last 2-3 years back. I mean, it was a few years back. And I asked him this funny question. Swamiji, aap to Advaita ke baare, you talk about Advaita, non-duality, sip and all those things. But you have so many temples in your ashram in Sringeri. Why do you have so many temples? Then he laughed. He said, you have found God inside. You go inside. Now, what about all those God people who have not found God inside? Where will they go? If all those people who have not found God inside, where will they go?
My God, great insight, Master. Great insight.
So this is not my... This came from the Sri Shankaracharya, Bal Gangadhar, Swami Bal Gangadhar, who is the senior pontiff of Sringeri. He's the descendant of Adi Shankara.
I'm surprised, Master. I'm really surprised.
Why are you surprised?
Master, because I used to think that it's an independent thought, which is, you know, like your own. But if it is like validated by him also, then
nothing of none of my thoughts are mine, dear. My dear, none of the thoughts are mine. I am nothing. I came with nothing and I will go with nothing. Don't think I am anything. I am a zero. Huh? I may be, you may be seeing me as 1000000000, but that one is him. If you remove that one, I am only zeros. When will we, as long as you don't realize you are a zero, you can't achieve anything. We are all zeros. But therefore, today, we had an interest. I hope you know the question left, because I don't like to interrupt. Anybody, the last question?
Sir, similar question, sir.
Yes.
Sir, when we believe that rebirth takes place, sir. So, sir, it is, can we believe that life between life, sir, that nowadays scientists also, they are trying to get in this life between life. They are trying to find out what is the life between life.
What is life? I didn't understand. Life between life.
Sir, yeah, sir. The duration, sir. Life between life, sir. Sir, they bolte na sir, swarg nark mein jaate sir, waisa.
Swarg nark.
Yeah, sir.
So what are you talking about? So put frame your question clearly. What are you telling? What therefore? What is your question?
Sir, after that, the rebirth. It is not necessary that rebirth will take immediately, sir.
It will obviously. It will take immediately, no?
It is okay, sir. That's the question, sir.
See, it's just like saying, if you send a WhatsApp to me, it will reach immediately or not?
Yes, sir. It will.
But if my phone is switched off?
No, sir. It will, after you on it, you, the phone.
And if you don't have data? So what I'm, so what I'm trying to tell you is, you are trying to ask questions which you know the answer. Normally, in a WhatsApp message, if you have data, if I have data, your phone is on, my phone is on, you send a message, I get a message. It's instant. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So it is like that. In a normal case, a person dies, he leaves the body. Sir. If he leaves the body, he carries his karma. He has nothing else to do. He has no business to go anywhere. He takes birth. Immediately, he takes birth in a mother's stomach, in a womb of a mother.
Yes.
If there is some hitch in the process, it may take its own time. Why are we bothered? See, Tushar, we are not bothered about these technical question and answer. We are only bothered about one thing, that we don't want to return to earth in a rebirth. We want to be liberated and we want to be united. That is the question we started with. The purpose of life is not to live in this monkey, circus. This life is nothing but a circus. It's a monkey show. We don't want to continue living like monkeys and donkeys and horses. We want to be free. We don't want to get pain of the body, misery of the mind, agony of the ego. We want to use our damn intellect and we want to be free. We want to stop this nonsense of suffering every day. And we want to become one with the divine. Well, my dear friends, that is the purpose of life. And we had some very interesting questions today. I thank you for your active participation to make the session a fulfilling session. And to each of you, who is none other than Sip, the supreme immortal power, I bow down to you and will see you tomorrow at 8.